Yep, the Lonergan boys, hot property in Aussie rugby right now, and they've been good enough to invite me out to the family farm in Williamsdale, about 40 minutes from the heart of Canberra. It is a beautiful part of the country, and I can't wait to see where it all began.
What about this joint, hey? How's the serenity?
Thanks for having me in.
No worries,
this
mate.
This looks unreal. You going to give me the tour?
Yeah, mate, yeah.
Cool. Right, after you guys.
Let's go.
Okay.
Guys, give us a rundown. You obviously grew up out here.
Yeah, we did. When we were real young, we actually grew up on a farm just up the road. And then when we were about 5 years old, we moved down to this place. Yeah, been here ever since.
What are some of the things you actually do around here to legitimise you as semi-farmers?
Well, Noss and I actually, in lockdown, we built a little orchard out the back. I help crutch the lambs, and then just chores. Noss does quite a lot of fencing. And then, yeah, I'm just making stuff up here.
Oh, I can see that.
Yeah. Oh, it's not bad.
So this is every match day, you're out here having a crack, bat and ball as well.
Every day.
Yeah. Every day. Yeah.
It's become a bit of a routine on game day though. Maybe two spells. Because okay. You don't want to be, no. You want to do a little something on game day, but not too much.
You go into Dan and say, I'm feeling a little
tough. Yeah, yeah.
I've just hit 100, Dan. I'm sorry.
We just had a 2020 at the farm.
Just got the bounce in the head.
Yeah. These like race bikes that we obviously don't ride much anymore.
When we were younger, we used to go down to Cooma for like race day and stuff.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, you used to play footy Saturday, go down Sunday, race.
Cutting around here and playing all these competitive sports, how did it sort of help shape you to where you are now as professional athletes?
Yeah, we have talked about that before, actually. I think that had a massive impact on where we are now. Like, Noss and I especially, just being out here, we had a little footy field out here. I actually had some goalposts set up just out the back here, and I used to kick a lot. And every arvo, we'd come play some footy, just kicking the ball, and then motorbike riding as well. We've got a track down there, but all three of us used to go down and compete against each other. And I think it just builds that competitive edge. But I think that really shaped us to who we are today. Okay. We've never really gotten too many fights. There was one fight. I punched him. And
I bet him in table tennis and he punched me in the face for it.
I'll never live it down either. It's so embarrassing.
So you put that to the side now. Yeah.
We've moved on.
I reckon that was our one and only like proper fight.
What's doing with this, mate? What's the plan?
I've just been rebuilding it for years.
It's meant to be on the road about 5 years ago, really.
How do you know how to build an engine?
YouTube.
Is that how you're doing it? YouTube?
Yeah.
Oh. Legit. What sort of car is it?
HQ Holden.
Okay.
What's the completion date set down for?
Oh, mate, honestly, don't know.
2036?
Yeah. And then I'll have to go back to the end of it and start again.
Yeah. Some rust issues in the chassis. Tell me more about the goalposts that you set up, how they come to be upright.
Oh, well, I'm a bit of a craftsman.
Yeah. I wouldn't say the upright either.
Yeah, there was just, because the old man's a builder as well as farmer, so he had a lot of spare timber left up at the shed. So I just screwed a couple bits of timber together and then some star pickets in the ground. And as long as the ball didn't hit the post right where the screw was, you're all right.
Especially with these little power pins.
So. Well, let's quickly touch on that. How is there so much power in such a tiny little set of getaway sticks? How did you land that kick against the Rebels?
Yeah, I don't really know, mate. I thought my range was sort of... I'm comfortable at 45. Yes, 55 was pushing it. I was quite nervous.
Can you believe like how bare the margin was that it crossed the crossbar as well?
Yeah, it only just made it over, and I did sneak a little bit.
I saw that.
Yeah.
So had you shifted it sort of in from the touchline a little bit?
I snuck it a little bit, because Damon was on it, like he said, like that's the mark, don't move it. And I reckon I sort of got it that far when I was just putting my tee down, like I was just trying to find a comfy spot. Well, like a comfy spot, and
sure.
It's just a bit further forward.
Yeah.
And I reckon it went over by about that much.
For the match winner, Lonergan has hit it well. Has hit it very well. Is it good enough? In the take it does!
Yeah, I think it's awesome. Like, I've sort of got used to being with Noss, and then the group of boys that we've got, we've grown up playing footy with as well. So I've sort of got very comfortable being around that group, and it's just like we're a family. Like, we pride ourselves in our Brumbies family, and then it's just so nice to be able to do it to this day from when we were young. So, yeah, I think that's something special.